you get a little fucking crazy. You know, I gotta tell you something. I gotta feel this place is a little bit crazy, cause this fucking place looks like a goddamn zoo, I'll tell you that much. Now I know every once in a while people like to take a little taste of alcohol. Now I'm not talking about no tequila. There's only one thing that's gonna get you. You know what I'm talking about? I can't hear ya! I can't hear ya! Cold shit!
Yeah.
You know, I'm sure you know. I tell you, the daytime, the takedown is an okay time. I tell you, but the nighttime, that's the right time for getting fucking crazy. Now, I want you all to know something. Every once in a while, everybody goes a little bit too far and does things they shouldn't be doing. Every once in a while, you hear a girl say to you, "Well, I didn't mean to take off my blouse last night. I didn't mean to lay down with you last night. I didn't mean to go all the way with you last night. But I tell you, there was a full moon and I was just getting fucking crazy." Here's a little song for all the people that don't need excuses. This one's called Creatures of the Night. And I tell you, there was a welcoming committee. I'm telling you, I saw some fine looking girls from St. Paul, from Minneapolis. Now those girls come over, I start looking them up and down. I grab me a hold of one of them. I squeeze it real tight. This other one says to me, "Where's Gene? Where's Gene Simmons?" Now I look at her, and she says to me, "I want you to meet Gene's little child." Now we look at her, I said to her, "Listen, I don't think Gene's ever seen you before, and that's not his baby. I want to tell you something, people. I lied. I remember that girl from the last time we came through. And that baby had the longest fucking tongue I've ever seen in my life." Now here's a little song. This one's off the Lick It Up album. This one's called Fits Like a Glove.
Yeah.
I want to know how many people here, how many of you people got friends who try to tell you you don't know what good rock and roll music is? I mean, how many of you people got friends who try to tell you Kiss sucks? You know what I say to those people? Fuck you! Well, I tell you something. I may say one thing, but Michael Jackson says something else. From nobody. Kiss is my favorite band. They're bad motherfuckers. I'm killing them. And you know what I say to all those people who say we suck? I say, fuck you! Now let me tell you something. If those people weren't home tonight, so uptight, if those people weren't home tonight watching Three's Company, if those people weren't listening to Duran Duran tonight, if those people weren't cutting out pictures from the newspapers of the Thompson twins, I know we could get those motherfuckers to come down here and you people would show them what rock and roll is all about! We're gonna want you to sing this one with us. This is real simple. Now I want everybody to do this. It's real easy. It goes like this. Ah, 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 ah. Can you do that? I know you can. All right, I'm gonna make it real simple so everybody's together. I'm gonna count to three. One, two, three. When you feel it's appropriate, and I want you people to sing this song because I think you know this one real well. This guitar came to me from heaven. Song goes like this.
Yeah.
people who think that Eric is like a cute little boy. Eric is built like a man, like a giant. We used to rent Eric out as a tripod. This one's called, Eric's gonna sing this one for you now. This one's called Young and Wasted.
Thank you.
Y'all creatures of the night. Thank you. Now you know, every time we go out on tour, we always come back here because we want to see you people, so I consider you people good friends, all right? Now I got a question for everybody here tonight. I want to know how many people are here. How many people? Well, let me, this is a private question, so let's, I want to know how many people are here. Lots of Snuck. Well, I'll tell you something. I went to the doctor yesterday to get myself checked out. I went to the doctor to get myself a physical examination. E-X-A-M-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Examination. I go into the doctor's office now. I was supposed to be there about 10:30. I walked in there. It must have been about 10:15. I got there before the doctor, but I go walk into his office. I see this nurse there with the biggest tits I've seen in a long time. I go sit down, I start reading my magazine. Now this girl's trying to make believe I'm not there, but she wants to tease me just a little bit. So she goes walking by me like this. Now I look at this girl, I say, excuse me, could you come over here for a minute? And she comes walking over to me, I say, you want to go to a party? She looks down at me and she says, where's the party? I said, the party's in my pants. And she looked at me and she said, well, if there's a party in your pants, I'm coming. Now all of a sudden she catches on, so she grabs a hold of me. I kind of spin her around. She goes, Paul, let's start this examination just a little bit early. I said, okay. She says, why don't you take off your shirt? Yeah! Now, I'm telling you, I'm a little shy, okay? I know I'm looking good this afternoon because I'm wearing my tight Levi's 501s. I want you to know these pants are so tight. These pants are so tight you can count the change in my pocket. Now this girl suddenly, she grabs a hold of my pants and she takes the first little snap in her hands and she goes, and I go, ah. Then she moves down just a little bit and she goes, and I go, uh-huh. And she moves her hand down just a little bit more and she goes, and then she opens up my pants. She takes her hand, now she makes sure that her hand's not too cold, and she sticks it down the front of my pants and I go, whoa! Then she takes her hand and wouldn't you know, she pulls out the whole damn thing. And she looks at me and she says, man, Paul, let me ask you something. What are you doing with that pistol down your pants? I said, your love, that ain't no pistol. I said to her, honey, that ain't no pistol. That's my... Yeah. Now this is real simple. Now if somebody sitting next to you doesn't want to sing, fuck them, okay? It's real simple. I'm gonna go like this. I go, I'm a street full of living. I'm gonna sing, pictures only begun, and you go, woo! Easy. I'm gonna count to three and then I wanna hear you, okay? One, two, three. I tell you something, you know, I was just thinking. We paid for some bigger crowds than this. But I tell you something, before this night's over, we're gonna make sure you motherfuckers are the loudest we've ever played for, are you? Alright, here we go.
Oh!
I lay my head down on the pillow and I think to myself, I am so glad that I've got a tongue. And I know there's some girls, who lay in bed at night and they say, man, I am so glad that guys have tongues in their mouths. Now here's a little song about putting it in your mouth. The song's called Lick It.
You know, this is a real celebrity audience tonight. If you look out there, you see Gene Simmons, you see Paul Stanley, you see them. They got their makeup on. They're looking good, and we're real proud of them. Now, we want you to help us out with this one. We're going to want you to help us out. We consider this song to be the rock and roll anthem. Now, we're going to want you to clap your hands. We're going to want you to get that rhythm beat going.
And party every day.
rock and roll all night. Party every night.